Take three. We've had people in and out of the studio all day today, so it's kind of been crazy. But I'm trying to show y'all how I start one of my paintings. And I do what is called a rub out first. And I basically just get the shape of the subject that I'm painting in first. And then once I get the kind of the basic shape, then I just take it from there. And I'll tweak it back and forth. Obviously, I'm pulling this dog's leg out and putting it back in and keeping it in line. So it's different than what a lot of folks do when they start a portrait or a piece. But it works for me. And it saves me a lot of trouble because I don't do underdrawings really. I mean, you know, detailed underdrawings. Some people do. They scale it all out and all that business. I just don't work that way. There's nothing wrong with working that way. It's just not the way I do it. So I'll go ahead and wipe out the pieces. And I guess I tend to work with the negative space as much as I do the positive space. And just get the basic lay of the land, or in this case, lay of the dog. I'm working on it. This dog's name is Daisy. And she is a little Jack Russell. She's as sweet as can be. And I photographed her here in the studio, and I'll probably use like my leather chair as some of the backdrop for the painting. So it just makes kind of a nice formal look. You know, you think of a dog portrait as not necessarily being formal, but they can be, and they make really good gifts that are stand up to the test of time. It's something that, and generally when I do these portraits, I try to make them so that they, they're not dated. I mean, these are things hopefully that will be around for hundreds of years. And even if somebody doesn't know who Daisy is, they think it's a really neat painting, and they'll still want to hang it, you know. That's kind of how I get it started, anyway. I've got to put some ears in here, so I want to get her ears erect. And we had time getting pictures of her with her ears up, so those will have to come in later. Like I said, this is just a basic kind of getting it laid in. I think I'm feeling pretty good about it now. I keep swapping between these pictures, and when I do a portrait, or any painting really for that matter, whether it's a portrait or a wildlife piece, I work from a ton of reference photos. I don't really work from just one. I work from a lot of different reference photos until I get, what I'm looking for. Oftentimes, I have an idea in my mind as to how I want the piece to look before I even start. So that's where the challenge lies in me finding or getting the right reference pieces. Because I tend to work backwards. I know what I want, I just have to try to create it. I'll take more later when I've actually done something more than just locked it in. But progress is progress, and we'll show you later, okay?